this is the site of a Pele tower built in the 15th century by the Cresswell family. And I'm in Cresswell, a Northumberland town on the northeast coast of England. And I thought I'd come and explore a little bit around this area. I can imagine once upon a time these grounds would be quite magnificent. They're sort of in ruins now. There's a lot of building debris. I'm assuming there were a lot more buildings here than there is now. So behind the tower here, I'm just going to walk along a very prominent, well-built wall. I'm guessing of the same period or similar. And I see a door here, so let's have a look through here, which is probably going to be a walled garden, I think. And as you can see, this would have been a magnificent kitchen garden, a walled garden, where all the vegetables would have been grown for the manor house. We have some structure still here. It's quite, again, I think it looks very much in the same time period as the wall was built. Obviously in ruin now, but could this have been a groundskeeper's cottage, maybe? Oh, there's a pheasant. Or an owl. No, it's an owl. Sorry, owl. Okay, so it's February, so it's not really very overgrown. I can imagine in the summer months this is very overgrown, but it's quite easy to get to here. But this looks like the original door. Very low door. Got a duck to get in there. There's a door through there. I think it would have been a single... Oh, might have been a... No, I think it's probably a single-story building. There's obviously, I think there are roof joist holes, you see in the wall there. And actually, there's an original wooden beam there. Again, more masonry on the floor. And remnants of, I guess, a tiled roof up there. It looks like a stone roof, slate, I don't know, can't tell. You can see where the roof originally was joined. So coming back out of there, that old cottage, looking back over here, you can see the Pele Tower again. But again, this probably was, there's lots of earthworks. A lot of these will be fallen logs. I mean, there's a fallen tree there in front of the Pele Tower. But I'm pretty sure this would have been quite a magnificent garden at one time. I'm not sure if that bar is from that window, which would be 7 to 9 foot off the ground there. No, you can actually see the original space there where the bar originally would have gone. I think those bars in there will be a later addition. Obviously locks, you can't get in. If the camera will pick this up, but yeah, just use for storage now. Some original masonry. I think that might have been repurposed to make a little step to see over the wall over to the coast. This is believed to be one of the original entrances to the 18th century mansion that was built. So my idea of the earthworks behind this, there's the Pele Tower, and I was just behind this wall, could very well have been part of the original mansion that was built there by the Cresswell family. One of the other hidden treasures in Cresswell is a part of an old manor house still existing above ground as part of the history of this area. And this was built in the 1820s. Again, I believe built by the Cresswell family. And what we have left is stable blocks that, as far as I'm aware, are not protected in any way and could potentially be knocked down at any time. Every time I come here, it saddens me that something like this is just rotting away. Should we go inside? We come into the courtyard. And we have that magnificent central tower, which I'm assuming had a clock on it one time. Sadly, the Vandals have got to it. It's a very impressive courtyard. Lots of graffiti everywhere. Fortunately, this is where the local youths come to drink, party, set fires. There's always a fire here if you pass at a weekend. I'm sure they'll be here tonight. And eventually this place is just going to just fall into so much ruin they'll have to flatten it. And it must have been some spectacular building at first. Obviously the roof's all gone, maybe a fire at one time, although there doesn't seem to be much in the way of fire damage. Maybe they took the roof off to protect it, I really don't know. So these would have been the stables in here. Again, pretty impressive just for horses. Sorry to all you horse lovers, but I mean, there's still wood there in there were certainly joists that would have put a second floor into here. I don't know if there was, I don't think they would have lived here, but maybe they did. Maybe stable hands lived here. So this is underneath the clock tower. Last time I was here, there was a bike suspended from... Oh, it's gone now. There was a bike suspended from up there. I think maybe on that wire. Some of the stairs still remaining. What they've done is, I'm assuming maybe to stop people getting any further, they've broken away that set of stairs just so people don't hurt themselves by climbing around these ruins. There's the back face of the clock tower up there. Again, I'm guessing this was another stable. That's clearly been bricked up recently. Well, it's modern cement. That's brick. That's a fireplace. So, well, that answers that question. Definitely was people were living above the stables then. That must have been the case. There's no above ground remnants of the 19th century manor house that this was associated with. None that I've seen. There is a curving row of columns we can go and have a look at later, which still survive. But I've never seen a ground plan of how the actual thing looked. So I don't know where it all ties in. Oh, I don't think this would be accessible when the weeds are growing even higher. Wow. Well, they're interesting. I wonder what was in there in those circular recesses. So, looking back through the courtyard, there's another door here. Very grand. Gotta watch the fallen masonry though. And, oh, little bird, hello bird. Oh, there's a wooden beam left down there. part of the original floor. Oh, fireplace. So this again was maybe for the stable hands, because it can get a bit cold up here in the north of England. More fallen masonry. Another fireplace. That looks like that's a steel beam. I don't know if there were any alterations done in the 20th century, but that looks more modern than the original building. So, how are we going to get through here? Let's have a look. No idea what's here. Oh, is that a staircase? Yeah. We've had a lot of rain and snow showers. Looks a little sketchy, but let's give it a go. Oh, there's a tree. Okay, got past there. And we're sort of on the first floor. There's the clock tower over the top, obviously. Roof's gone, as I said. Beautiful stonework though, and this is into the other, well, as you're facing the clock tower, this will be the right hand side of the courtyard. Right, I'm going to have to try and get back down there again. Okay, so this is the rear side of the right wing of the stable block, and as you can see outside there is some more masonry standing. We've got this wall here, which I'm not really sure of its function, whether it's something was happening in here, but as you can see over there, we've got quite a significant above ground piece of archaeology, which I'm not really sure of the function. You've also got to be careful if you come here, because there are a lot of fish ponds and pits, perhaps wells, that through the course of time have been covered by leaves, fallen wood, debris. So just be careful where you step, and don't try and video at the same time as you're walking. Oh, right. But here, look. Where we are here, there's some curbing stones of some foots of maybe a wall of some description. There's clearly been a building here. Go up here, as you can see. Yeah, we've got more masonry. So this was, whether it edged a road, I mean, it looks quite flat, so maybe that was a road into something else over there. Not sure, but this is, I mean, I'm constantly walking on brick, tile. See, there's wood, but we've got this thing here. It's magnificent. This is just going to eventually crumble. This area, I believe, is owned by the caravan park, which bought it quite some time ago. And I do hope that they use this as even a part of their attraction. Maybe had a woodland walk through it. Clearly, it's being managed, because as you can see, a lot of the branches that have fallen have been chipped, and it looks like they've been felling some of the trees, so maybe they're going to do something. I would like to think they would, and I'll be very happy if they do. But I mean, it's just magnificent. But its function, I'm not sure. Maybe part of a garden feature. It's a heck of a garden feature if it is. There's a doorway, which is a long way off the floor. So did that lead to this building we've just walked over, maybe? I don't know. As Big Clive would say, I'm not 100% sure. So let's have a look around here. So there's the caravan park just over through those trees. Yeah, I mean, it's a hell of a structure. So Some dressed stone down here, some more dressed stone over there. But I mean, look at it. How cool is that? Imagine clearing a bit of this and having a, I don't know, putting a stage in there. I don't know. Just something. This is the sort of stuff that we've got to preserve before Northumberland Council decide to knock it down, if they're anything like other councils around here. It's just a crying shame when these things are just left to rot. This is our heritage, this is our history. We really need to look after this stuff. And I think it's all well and good clearing area to build on because it's more profitable. But come on, you know, you've got to keep some of this stuff. You've got to protect it for our kids and our kids' kids. There's nothing more cool than finding stuff like this, but if it's not managed, it's just going to rot. It's going to be vandalised and eventually flattened to build more houses. Yeah, I know we need houses, but the truth of it is, do we need houses here? I know what I think. Man, this is just wonderful. If I win the lottery, I bought a ticket today. If I win the lottery, if I win 20 million, I'm going to buy this plot of land and I'm going to look after it. Look at that. How wonderful. So it looks like this, the idea, I wonder if this was like a garden walkway, like a covered walkway, an incredibly elaborate one. Because there seems to be a flat area in the middle with maybe, was there something on the other side as well? I don't know. Let's have a look, let's walk through here. Seems reasonably flat. I don't know if this could have just been a... I'm not sure. Whatever it is, we love it. And it's not far from the... there's the stable block through the trees.